Hi, I'm Duncan.
And I'm Jessica, and we lived life like everybody else. We had a house, a car payment, a big TV, and a regular 9-to-5 job to try and pay for it.
When one day we got rid of it all to live life on the road, and now we're leaving mainstream society and making every day different by traveling on the outskirts. This is day 3, and we're still at Yellowstone Park.
Sucker love is heaven sent you. Pucker up our passion spent. My heart's its art, your body's rent. My body.
This is Blacktail Plateau Drive. It's a 6-mile dirt road that gets you off the paved road, and it's highly recommended. Lots of open space.
I lie here charmed, cause there's nothing else to do. Every me and every you. Sucker love, a box I choose. No other box I choose.
This is a petrified tree here in Yellowstone. It actually got petrified over 50 million years ago when a bunch of volcanoes erupted and then encased it and turned it basically into stone.
Things to come, too much poison come undone. Cause there's nothing else to do. Every me and every you.
Tower Fall got its name for the towering rocks above it, but there's so much more around here. When you first get here, there's a boardwalk to walk down there so you can actually view Tower Fall. But if you look to your right, there's a little path, a dirt path. Go down it. It's a very long hike to get back up, but it's so worth it. It leads down to the pebble beach of Yellowstone River, which is so fast right here. It's falling. And then there's little tiny streams that are interconnecting, so you can really explore a whole lot of stuff down here on the beach, as well as listen to the fall.
Every me and every you, every me.
You can see how Mud Cauldron got its name, because it's basically a big cauldron of churning mud.
So just how far down do you want to go? Well, we could talk it out over a cup of joe, and you could look deep in.
This is Mud Volcano. Early explorers most likely saw a 30 by 30 foot volcano shaped cone, and then afterwards, sometime, half of the cone blew off, and now we're left with just a small crater here, but it's still awesome. It just continuously boils.
You and me, baby, no one else we could trust. We'll say nothing to no one, no how, or we bust and never crack.
A lot of people think that the smell smells like rotten eggs. It's actually hydrogen sulfide. Personally, I think that it smells like fireworks.
So this is Dragon Mouth Spring. It got its name because one of the workers saw that the water was lapping out like a dragon's tongue. But I can see how you would think that there would be a dragon in there with all the smoke pluming out, and there was just the rumble coming from all the waves bouncing around inside, and the smell. It'd be cool if the dragon was voiced by Sean Connery. Good gosh, with my park. So this is it. This is Old Faithful. They say it shoots off every 90 minutes, give or take a half an hour. And when it does go, it can last from a minute and a half to 5 minutes. They say it's got its name because of its consistency when the first explorers came here. But it turns out it's not the most consistent anymore, and its eruptions are getting farther and farther apart as time passes. Well, that about wraps up our time here at Yellowstone, and wraps up the end of day 3. Tomorrow we're going to be back on the road again, trying to make it to Salt Lake City, so we'll see you on the road, traveling on the outskirts.